Day 3 of the 2016 budget debate saw PPP Civic Member of Parliament Vindya Prasad taking a stand for the rights of women. She chastised the government, saying that the budget lacks tangible projects for the empowerment of women.
Women represent 50% of our country's population, Mr. Speaker, and investing in women's capability and empowering them to exercise their choices contributes to economic growth, overall development, and the future financial status of their children. Because it is well known, Mr. Speaker, that children mirror their mother's financial status.
Prasad told the House that the $230 billion budget has failed to deliver transformative initiatives which will impact on women's financial and skill development.
Women work long hours, both as primary and secondary income earners, at the expense of their health and at the expense where their children and families may be neglected. Mr. Speaker, I would have been heartened to hear initiatives to remove some of the burdens of our women, including minimal cost daycare facilities for parents, special programs for teenage mothers, parenting programs, support programs for widows, survivors of trauma, violence and abuse.
Prasad nonetheless maintained that the 2016 budget has failed the people of Guyana, particularly women who continue to be at the bottom of the pay grade.
By having money circulating at all levels with disposable income, money moves from the seamstress, the bookseller, the shopkeeper, to the higher levels in the business sector. But Budget 2016 is a damn squib.
Her colleague on the opposing side of the House, Social Protection Minister Valda Lawrence, rebutted, outlining that the ministry has over $9 billion to expend in 2016, and that much of that will go towards embarking on several new programs that will benefit all, especially women and children.
Prior to this budget, I did extend an invitation to the Honorable Member, Ms. Prasad, who spoke before me. Had Ms. Prasad taken up that invitation, sir, I would have been able to explain to her and to inform her of the policies that we are embarking on and also of the various programs.